today. Amen. I have some good news for you this morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I got some good news.
Amen.
Amen. Jesus is alive and well.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is alive and well. Amen. He sends us a message of good news. If you would turn to Psalms 23. You know that 23:1 was a verse we read this morning in devotion, saying that the Lord is our shepherd, and I shall not want. But for this message today, we're going to go down to number 5. Psalms 23, verse 5. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Hallelujah. Our thought for the day, my cup runneth over.
Amen.
My cup runneth over. I mean, in this scripture passage, David has been through some things in his life, and he had a moment to reflect on what God had done for him.
All right.
How God had been with him in the presence of his enemies.
Yeah.
How God had helped him to go through the green pastures. Mm-hmm. He had restored his soul after he had damaged people.
Yeah.
Killed, had people killed. Uh-huh. The things that, you know, sometimes we make the excuse that, well, I've done too much. Mm-hmm. God won't save me. Oh, but David is declaring what God has done for him. And I want you to know what God did for David, he'll do for you.
Yeah.
He has done for me.
Yeah.
See, I haven't always been walking in righteousness.
All right.
But I thank God for grace and for mercy.
Yeah.
So I invite you to stop today and reminisce. Think about all the things that you've been through.
All right.
When you couldn't see your way out.
Yeah.
But God.
But God.
God made a way. Sometimes, you know, we get through a situation and we're already on the other side and we stop and say, I don't know how I got here. But I thank God. See, God is working. His angels are at our beck and call. We have angels assigned to me. I've got my own special angels. You've got your angels. So we need to use them.
Yeah.
And then we need to know that with the Lord as our shepherd,
yes,
our cup will run over.
All right. Yeah.
Hallelujah. As we look at this verse 5, so thou preparest a table before me.
Uh-huh. All right.
See, some of us are living in God, and all we want is a ham sandwich.
All right. Uh-huh.
But I want a smorgasbord.
All right. Yeah.
I want to be able to choose what I got to eat, what I want to eat, what I want to do.
Man.
The Lord said everything belonged to him.
Yes.
Why would he say he prepared a table before me and all I got is a peanut butter and jelly sandwich?
All right.
Mm. I can eat that in my hand. I don't need the table set.
All right. Come on.
But when the Lord prepares the table, you need to sit down and feast.
Yes.
On what he has prepared for you.
My God.
And so you have a variety so that he can attend to your every need.
Yes.
If you need healing,
yes,
you got it.
Yes.
If you need a job,
yes,
he's got it.
Yes.
If you need salvation,
yes,
he's got it.
My God.
It's all at the table. And guess what? The table is spread. It's like a buffet.
Yes.
You don't go to a buffet and just have one or two items. But you have a whole spread of things that you can choose from. And everything that comes from God is good.
Yes.
It's good to you and it's good for you.
Yes.
So you can eat of the table of life from God, because his children,
yes,
he has prepared.
Yes, Lord.
He, and all we have to do is call it into existence.
Yes.
By faith, we shall receive.
Yes.
And he goes a step further, and he says, in the presence of my enemies.
Yes.
In the presence.
Yeah.
He spread it out for me. All the while my enemies are digging ditches.
Yeah.
While they sit back and hide their hands and wonder why did not fall in. God has prepared a way out of no way.
Yeah.
He did it for me. He'll do it for you.
Yeah.
In the presence of my enemies, where they are confused and don't even know what they're doing. They don't understand why their tricks didn't work out.
Uh-huh.
They don't know the God we serve.
Yeah.
David is declaring, when I was running for my life,
yeah,
out in the wilderness,
my God,
I didn't have to eat grasshoppers.
All right.
God prepared a table for me.
Yeah.
In the presence of my enemies. When I could have taken somebody's life,
yeah,
God spared their life and restored me so I didn't feel evil against them.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
That's what God would do if we allow him,
amen,
to lead us.
Right.
Our cup runneth over.
Yeah.
Runneth over. The next part of that verse says, thou anointest my head with oil.
Yeah.
And some people don't understand why we use the oil,
mm-hmm,
or the olive oil. The olive oil, and that's a whole other sermon about the olive oil, but the anointing is just like a baptism.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Baptism is a sign, a symbol,
yeah,
that you trust God, you confess it over to God, and you're going to be a Christian.
Yeah.
An outward symbol. Anointing with oil is an outward blessing.
Yes.
A showing that I'm praying God's favor on your life.
Yeah.
When we pray for people, we anoint them with oil because we're praying God's blessing upon those
Amen.
People.
Amen.
That God will find favor,
yes,
and answer their needs.
Mm.
Prepare the table,
yeah,
before them.
Yeah.
Now the oil, the olive oil, it's, you know, if you get a green olive with the nuts still in it, and you mash that olive, it doesn't come out looking like clear oil, green oil. It's white and milky.
Yeah.
But the history says you have to beat the olive.
That's right.
With the nut still in it, the
yeah,
seed still in it.
Right.
Beat it, and then you get oil.
That's right.
It represents Christ beating.
Yes.
Yes.
I mean,
damn
it. Now that's a whole nother sermon.
Damn it.
But I'm trying to get you to understand the importance,
mm-hmm,
of what the olive oil represents.
Yeah.
See, some people don't understand why we use oil. But I want the Lord to cover you,
yeah,
and attend to your needs.
Yeah.
And lay a table.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Woo. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
It's a symbol,
yes,
of blessings.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah, I need to anoint everybody in here today.
Yeah.
But there's a sign,
yeah,
that I want God to bless you.
Yeah.
You're already blessed. When you walk in the door, see, that's Trinity's prayer.
Yes.
Every soul that come in here,
yes,
is blessed.
Amen.
But sometimes we need to show you that the outward symbol,
yes,
of being blessed.
Yeah.
So that you physically get covered.
Yeah.
But he said, anointed my head with oil. Hallelujah. We remember how David was anointed to be king. And the other brothers, that wouldn't work.
Right.
Because God has his chosen.
Yeah.
That he knows have a heart for him and will do what he said he would do.
Yeah.
And so to be anointed, to be blessed that you will grow up and carry out God's will,
uh-huh,
is something special. David said, he anointed my head with oil. That's kind of like pouring.
Uh-huh.
Pouring oil alone.
Yeah.
and watching the glow of salvation rise up.
Yes.
Hallelujah. This is good news, y'all.
Yes.
What God will do for his children.
Yes.
How God is doing for his children.
Yes.
And we have to recognize who he is and then what he is to us. We need to think about or where he brought us from when we couldn't take care of ourselves. He says, my cup runneth over. It didn't say my cup ran over. No, that's just a one-time thing.
That's right.
It didn't say my cup will run over.
That's right.
But it said it runneth.
Yeah.
That's past, present, and future.
Yeah.
Continual faith. You and me, I got you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whatever you need, when you need it.
Yeah.
See, the thing about the God that I serve, that he blesses more. He blesses abundantly.
Yeah.
He will give you more than you need.
Yeah.
Do you remember how he had the two fish in the fire hose, right?
Yeah.
When they all ate, they had too much.
Yeah.
They take up the baskets of the leftovers.
Right.
He's not going to give you just what you need, but he'll give you more. When the Israelites were traveling through the desert, trying to make it to the promised land, they asked for manna from heaven.
Uh-huh.
He gave them more.
Yeah.
He said, but don't you save none for tomorrow.
Right.
I'm going to give you some more tomorrow.
Yeah.
That's,
right.
That's the God I serve.
Yeah.
That's the God that's my cup.
Amen.
Running
Amen.
Over.
Yeah. That's right.
Hallelujah.
Now there's a song that says, fill my cup, though.
Mm-hmm.
I lift it up.
Yeah.
I wonder if you're lifting up your cup.
All right.
Or if you're doing like me, when I wash my cup, I turn them down in the dish drain.
All
right. Is your cup turned down?
Come on now.
Then nothing can go in.
All right.
Are you allowing the Lord or asking the Lord to fill your cup?
Yes.
With goodness, with righteousness, with mercy, with grace, with peace, with finances, with health. Are you asking God? Are you lifting up your cup?
Yes.
Oh, my cup runneth over. But whatever I need. See, I might not need the same thing today that I needed yesterday.
Right. Yes.
But whatever I need, my God will supply.
Yes.
I want the Lord to fill my cup.
Jesus.
I don't want to fill it. Because if I feel it, I might have left some trash in it.
That's right.
That junk. That stuff we holding on to.
Yeah.
But if we ask the Lord to fill our cup, it's going to be clean before he starts pouring. See, his holiness does not go in an unclean vessel.
That's right.
The vessel got to be clean.
Yeah.
Lift your cup and let God lift. Let God fill your cup.
Right.
Thank you.
Oh, my cup runneth over. It runs
over.
More than enough.
More.
But you know what? I can't even give it to you.
That's right.
The part that's running over.
Yeah.
You got to want it for yourself.
Yeah.
You got to desire it for yourself.
Yeah.
You got to ask for yourself.
Right.
And ask the Lord to fill my cup.
That's a word.
Lord, I lift it up.
Yeah.
See, I just hold my cup.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. For the righteous to come by and pour in it. Oh, but I'm lifting this cup.
Yeah.
Because I want you to fill it up. My heart desire is for the Lord to fill my cup.
Yeah.
With whatever I need. Lord, you know what I need tomorrow.
Yes, yes.
You fill it.
Yes.
With that patience.
Yes.
With that humbleness. With that obedience. Yes. Whatever it's going to take for me to make another day.
Yeah.
I need the Lord. To fill my cup.
Right.
It runneth over.
Jesus.
But is it running over with mess?
Alright.
With junk.
Yeah.
With filth.
Right.
What are you allowing in your cup?
Mm.
Or are you allowing anything in your cup? We have to make a step ourselves and lift it up. And lift it up. Because when we lift it up, we're asking God. And if I'm holding, I just put it on the table. You feel it if you want to feel it. That doesn't work. doesn't work. Well, I come to church, he ought to fill my cup sometime. Ask him. And as you're asking, I mean you, Lord Jesus. I mean you. Now he better come to me. At least I came to church. Oh, that's wrong, y'all.
Amen.
We have to humble ourselves down and ask. He knows our heart desire. We have to ask. Ask him. The song said, tell him what you want.
Yeah.
Call him up.
Call him up.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Lift your cup up. My cup runneth over. Runneth over because I have a desire to live right. I have a desire to be more, to be more like him, to be more loving, to be more obedient, to be more kind, to be more humble. It's my heart's desire, so I ask God every day, fill my cup. Fill it up, Lord. Hallelujah. The things that I want to do may not be what you want me to do.
All right.
I need you, Lord, on the inside. My cup runneth over.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So can yours. So that you won't have to worry.
Yes.
Will I have?
Yeah.
Can I get?
Yes.
You just start reaching from your cup. Drinking from your cup. Because it's in there. And it will never. Jesus said his well will never run dry.
Yeah.
Never run dry. The will of me about. Never run dry.
My God.
Hallelujah. That's the God I serve.
Amen.
And I want to invite you today to get the cup. It may not be clean. It may not be sparkling clean. But if you ask God to fill your cup, he will clean it.
Right.
He will clean it. So you can't get it as spotless as God can.
Right.
But if you lift it up to him, Lord, I come. The song says, just as I am. I come just as I am. Lord, I need a change.
Yes.
I need more of you.
Yes.
My desire is to have more of you, Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
So I lift up my cup in whatever state it's in.
Yes.
And I ask you, Lord Jesus, to fill it up.
Fill
it up, Lord Jesus.
Fill it.
And let it overflow.
Yes.
My cup runneth over, continually runneth over. Because that's my heart's desire.
Yes.
And I lift it. I lift it.
Yeah.
I encourage you today. Don't be lacking. Whatever your need, whatever your desire.
Yeah.
The God that I serve.
Yes.
He's got the answer.
Yeah.
He's got the answer.
Yeah.
Whatever you need today.
Yeah.
He's got the answer.
That's right.
Lift up your cup.
All right.
Yeah.